Hi friends, good evening. This is Dr. Harinath Reddy, Director, Shankaran IAS Study Circle. So today we will take up one more important topic under Andhra Pradesh economy. So I will put the question this way and I will try to explain the question. Discuss the injustices meted out to the successor state of Andhra Pradesh at the time of bifurcation and post bifurcation by Government of India. In other words, at the time of bifurcation and even after bifurcation, what are the several injustices which were done to the state of Andhra Pradesh? This is a very important topic. I would like the viewers to take more attention while listening to this video. If you see the background in which the undivided state of Andhra Pradesh was bifurcated, there was no unanimity, there were no adequate consultations with all the political parties and different stakeholders, and it was done arbitrarily, unscientifically, undemocratically, bulldozing the entire parliament. And even if you see the experience in the last more than 5 years, injustice was done to the state of Andhra Pradesh. For example, so when power was allocated between the state of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, instead of the location being the basis for power allocation, power was allocated on the basis of consumption. As a result, Andhra Pradesh had lost. Similarly, refund of tax liability was made on the basis of population at 58% for AP and 42% for Telangana, and Andhra Pradesh was a loser because it has very, very limited revenue generation sources for refunding the tax liability. Telangana with less population has been given more resources, and Andhra Pradesh with more population has been given less resources. Given this context, ideally, refund of tax liability should have been more on Telangana rather than on Andhra Pradesh. In addition to this, assets have been given on the basis of their location, and as a result, Telangana stood benefited very hugely compared to the state of Andhra Pradesh, because most of the important assets were located in the capital city of Hyderabad, which was given to the state of Telangana. Then similarly, if you see the impact in several sectors of economy, immediately after bifurcation, if you see the sectoral contribution of the three sectors to GSDP, that is agriculture sector, industrial sector and services sector, Andhra Pradesh has been reduced to be a predominantly agrarian state. So the contribution of agriculture and allied sectors to the GSDP of Andhra Pradesh is around 31.77% compared to Telangana, which is 15.34%, Tamil Nadu 11.39%, Karnataka 11.68%. Same is the story even when industry is taken into account. If you see the contribution of industrial sector to the state GSDP, in the state of Andhra Pradesh, it is less than 20%. But in Telangana, it is 22.10%, Tamil Nadu 31.72%, and even in Karnataka, it was 23.68%. Even if you take the All India figure, it was much higher than Andhra Pradesh, which stood at 29.02%, which means post bifurcation, Andhra Pradesh became a less industrialized state. Same is the case with the service sector. So if you see the contribution of service sector to the overall GSDP, it is around 46% in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Compare this with other neighboring states in South India. In Telangana, it is a 62.56%. Tamil Nadu 56.88% and Karnataka 64.44%. Even the national average is 53.66%. So this clearly shows that Andhra Pradesh is also languishing in services sector despite having a rich, talented human resources in the state of Andhra Pradesh. See, the strength of service sector depends on industrial base, which is weak in the state of Andhra Pradesh. See, if you take most of the important institutions in the undivided state of Andhra Pradesh, they were allocated between Telangana and Andhra Pradesh on the basis of location. As a result, 90% of the institutions have gone to Telangana. There was not even a single national institution of repute which has remained in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Of course, Government of India had promised setting up of a number of national institutions of repute in the successor state of Andhra Pradesh, but the rate of funding is slow and the pace of work is also slow, and it will take another 2 to 3 decades for these institutions to become a reality. See, the other injustices which were met to the state of Andhra Pradesh after bifurcation. See, the then Prime Minister of India, Dr. Manmohan Singh, had given several assurances on the floor of Rajya Sabha in February 2014. Some of these assurances include special category status for 5 years, industrial incentives to the successor state of Andhra Pradesh on the lines of special category states, which number 11. He also promised assistance to the backward districts in the state of Andhra Pradesh, similar on the lines of Bundelkhand and KBK districts in Odisha. He also made assurances to include the 7 mandals in Khammam districts, which will be affected by the Polavaram project, to be included in the state of Andhra Pradesh. He also made a promise that the assets and liabilities will be distributed among the 2 states to the satisfaction of both the states. He also made another promise that the revenue deficit which the government of Andhra Pradesh will suffer because of bifurcation from the appointed day, that is the day on which the state came into force, and the recommendations of the 14th Finance Commission will be compensated by the central government. So which means the central government had to compensate the revenue deficit for 10 months from June 2014 to March 2015. So take the first issue, which is the special category status, which was promised by then Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh and even the present Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So during the election campaign, in the 2019 elections in the state of Andhra Pradesh, Modi has made the following statement: Congress killed the mother and saved the child. Had I been there, I would have saved the mother too. Which means Modi said that he would have saved even the state of Andhra Pradesh from suffering losses. People of Andhra Pradesh have been waiting for the last 5 years that Mr. Modi would save the mother, but that didn't happen in the last 5 years. In addition, the government of India has brought in an argument that if Andhra Pradesh is given special category status, other states in the neighborhood of Andhra Pradesh will also demand for special category status, which means Bihar, Odisha have been demanding for special category status since a long time. But the context of Andhra Pradesh is different from Bihar and Odisha. The reason is, in the case of Andhra Pradesh, this special category status was a promise given by the decision of the cabinet, the highest policy making body in the country, and also the then Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh. So an assurance which is given by the cabinet at the highest level and even the Prime Minister at the highest level cannot be ignored, and so cannot be compared with states like Bihar and Odisha. And such an announcement was made in the context of bifurcation of Andhra Pradesh and the several losses which Andhra Pradesh had suffered because of bifurcation. If you take BJP, In the 2014 manifesto for assembly elections in Andhra Pradesh, the manifesto said that special category status will be given not for 5 years but for 10 years. Even Prime Minister Modi, in his meetings in Guntur, in Nellur, in Tirupati, in front of Lord Balaji in 2014 election campaign, also promised to give special category status for 10 years. Later on, the Prime Minister, the current Prime Minister, and Government of India had a number of excuses for not conferring special category status on the state of Andhra Pradesh. According to Article 4 of the Indian Constitution, when any state is bifurcated under Article 3, then supplemental, incidental, and consequential measures can be taken by Parliament. And this was even upheld by the Supreme Court in Pradeep Chaudhary and Mulla Periyar cases repeatedly. See, the very bifurcation of the state of Andhra Pradesh is agreed on the promise of giving special category status. So giving special category status is supplemental, incidental, and consequential to bifurcation. And the Union Government in 2016 has created a subgroup of chief ministers to decide whether the special category status which was conferred to the 11 states in Northeast India and Himalayan hilly region, whether that should be continued or not. But the subgroup of chief ministers had recommended continuing special category status to the Northeast and hilly states. Based on the recommendations of subgroup of chief ministers, Niti Aayog had issued a memorandum in 2016 whereby it was decided to continue the special category status benefits to those states. But when it came to the state of Andhra Pradesh, Government of India, the finance minister, made an excuse that they cannot confer special category status on the state of Andhra Pradesh because 14th Finance Commission has recommended not to confer special category status to any state. But Minister of Planning had categorically said that the Finance Commission, that is the 14th Finance Commission, had never recommended not to confer special category status on any state. The demand for special category status to the state of Andhra Pradesh was even supported by two chief ministers from Bihar and Puducherry. In September 2016, the then Honorable Finance Minister Arun Jaitley made a statement that a special package would be given which will be equal to that of special category status. Even this special package was not delivered to the state of Andhra Pradesh. So the industrial incentives which were promised by Dr. Manmohan Singh to the successor state of Andhra Pradesh on the lines of special category status were also not implemented with respect to state of Andhra Pradesh. Finance Minister again took an excuse saying that industrial incentives given to special category status will no longer exist post GST implementation, which is not true. The industrial incentives even post GST implementation are being continued for special category status for special category states, but denied to the state of Andhra Pradesh. This is clearly a case of discrimination towards the state of Andhra Pradesh by Government of India. If you take one more important development on 21st March 2018, the Union Ministry of Commerce and Industry approved a Northeast Industrial Development Scheme in which these industrial incentives were given to the Northeast states up to March 2020 with a financial outlay of rupees 3000 crores, but the same was denied to the state of Andhra Pradesh. Section 46, Clause 3 of Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act talks about special development package for backward districts in Andhra Pradesh. So this is a statutory requirement on the part of Government of India to fulfill, and accordingly, Modi government had given 1050 crores for 7 districts for 3 years. But if you compare the money given to the state of Andhra Pradesh for 7 districts with what is given for 3 districts in Odisha under KBK and Bundelkhand, this amount appears to be very minimal. Bundelkhand was given a package of 7,200 crores, KBK was given 5,500 crores, just for 3 districts. If you see the per head allocation and compare it with Andhra Pradesh, in Bundelkhand per head allocation was ₹4,115, but Andhra Pradesh per head allocation is just ₹428.57. So this is again a clear case of discrimination towards the state of Andhra Pradesh. In addition, Government of India recently has given defense industrial corridor worth ₹20,000 crores for Bundelkhand. In addition, Section 94 Class 3 of Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act 2014 says that a financial support for creation of essential facilities in the new capital of Andhra Pradesh would be provided by Government of India. How much is the money given for the capital city of Amaravati? Just 1500 crores. But if you compare this with the money which is spent for the Patel statue in Gujarat and a Shivaji statue in Maharashtra, the money given for the capital of Amaravati is low. 3500 crores is the money which is spent for Patel statue in Gujarat. 3000 crores is the money which is spent for Shivaji statue in Maharashtra. But the money which is given for the city, for the greenfield capital of Amaravati, is just 1500, which is very paltry amount. In addition to these, the other injustices which the state of Andhra Pradesh had suffered is because of the vague wording in the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act. The words like examine, feasibility are so deliberately drafted, providing an escape route for Government of India from fulfilling its commitments to the successor state of Andhra Pradesh. See the rate of funding which is given for establishing central institutions in the state of Andhra Pradesh. So far, the money given for establishing 11 central institutions in the successor state of Andhra Pradesh is just 638 crores, whereas the requirement is 11,673 crores. Because of paltry funding, the works are going at a snail's pace, and at this rate of funding, it would take 20 to 30 years for completing the construction of these 11 central institutions. That's it about the injustices which were met to the state of Andhra Pradesh at the time of bifurcation and post-bifurcation. So it is already too late for Government of India. The Government of India must be sensitive to the concerns of the state of Andhra Pradesh and true to the spirit of cooperative federalism, which Modi speaks about very frequently. He must come to the rescue of the state of Andhra Pradesh and the people of Andhra Pradesh to put them on the track of high growth trajectory, promoting inclusive growth, creating employment opportunities, and achieving inclusive development and sustainable development in the long run. Thank you. That's it in this video.